Welcome, everyone. This is Michelle Laura Romero with Rethinking Life. I bring strategic players to you, someone in the know, and someone generous enough with their time. This gentleman right here with me is Michael De Leon. He is a financial advisor, and you're going to want to know his name. I've been wanting to do this with you for a while because I just want to really collaborate with straight shooters, and that's Mike. We're going to bring value to you as much as we can, and what do you think, Mike?
No, that's good. We've always talked back and forth for a long time, and here we are now. We can share some of this information with you guys out there.
Very good. So this is Rethinking Life. This guy is rethinking life all the way. He changes people's lives in the work that he does. Tell us a little more about what you do, Mike.
So what I do is I bring a service. I help families with their financial issues, which is a big, big problem in America today, as you know. Debt is an issue. People work in jobs that they don't like. And they actually say about 80% of people today work in a job that they don't care for. And they're frustrated, and the money problems and things like that. And really what I like to do is just sit down with those families and show them a way, show them a plan so that they can reach their goals and their dreams, because everybody has goals and dreams.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times they just don't share them.
True. Going back to what you said about people, 80% of people not liking their jobs, I would like to see people think of their job as more of a tool to get them where they want to be instead of feeling helpless in their job. That's my experience. I see so many people that just struggle day to day. Like we've talked about before, they can't wait until their weekend, when really you should be grinding in your job, putting in as many hours as you can so that you can get different streams of income out there and get rid of your debt so that you can actually move on to something that you enjoy more. Mm-hmm. And that's something that Mike and I have both done.
Yes. I think it's very important that you find that passion that you of something you really want to do. You can still have a job and go make that income, because that's very important to you and your family. But at the same time, if there's a passion that you really want to do, you can't tell me there's not a way to enhance what you want to do and figure it out, whether it's through learning or just picking up a book and reading. I mean, the sources are there. They're all out there, so there's no excuses.
Absolutely. So there's something that I want to get out there for all of you, and that is getting in power. This is part of the process. You know, really, like Mike said, information is power and so is action. So this, and genuinely, we want to help all of you get back in power of your life so that you can do what you are actually meant to do. And I'm sure some of you have lost that. But others of you have this kind of internal wisdom of something that, like, you're so passionate about. Just like I have my own passions, Mike has his own passions, and that is what you're supposed to be doing. So we're gonna help guide you in any way that we can here today, and then we'll be having more podcasts in the future to help you take the steps, you know, like debt freedom. That's a huge step, because when you're stressing about your finances, you cannot possibly be living your purpose.
That is correct.
Wouldn't you agree?
Totally agree. Because that's all that's on your mind. You're so worried every day you wake up, you're like, the debt's still there. And every day you're waking up stress. And your family knows it. They can feel it. They can see it. Your kids know it. They can feel it. They can see it. So what people don't realize is that all you need is a plan. That's all it takes, a step-by-step plan to walk you through to get rid of that debt a lot sooner so that you can have a little more financial freedom for you and your family, and not to mention the extra money that's coming in every month because you're not putting it all on debt. Mm-hmm. So it's not that hard. It's just more about putting a plan together.
And also about that mindset, because if you heard Michael's story or you heard my story, you know, we could be those people that said, like, it's too hard, I don't have the tools, I don't have the support always, I may not have the job that pays the best, but that is no reason. There's always a way. Yes, you may have a bad situation, but it can always be made better, because we're trying to manage certain things in our life, and I promise you, as a mother of four, like, I'm working so hard to grind to get where I want to be, and there are no excuses, because just like Michael has children also, like, we are building the foundation for these children so that they don't have to struggle like we did. They are going to be elevated by what they're seeing us do, and that's super important.
Yes, and it's good to have those goals and set those goals and commit to them. Most people, the reason why they're still in debt, even after so many years are going by, because they didn't commit to getting out of debt. There's a difference between talking about getting out of debt and actually doing it. And if you get a plan in place, you got to commit to that plan each step and go with it to get out of debt as soon as possible. Because I tell you, when you're debt-free, it makes life a lot easier.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So we want to know how you got here.
Great. So almost 10 years ago, I had a job. I'm working a job just like most people, full-time. I enjoyed what I did at that time, but I just come to the point where I go, wait a minute, am I really helping anyone right now? Where's the purpose in my life? Do I want to keep doing this job for another 10, 15, 20 years? And it's just it's basically one of those things where you go, you know what? I need to do something else. So that's what I did. And I already knew what I wanted to do to help other people. And that was in the financial services industry, where I can help people get out of debt, become properly protected and debt-free, financial independence. And what I realized is that there was nothing really out there for the middle class, which only covers 98% of this country. So I jumped on board with a company that helped do exactly that and just push forward. And now, almost 10 years later, I've helped so many families get out of debt, build their financial independence over the years, so when they retire, they'll be good to go. They don't have to worry about money. And it's a great feeling to do that. It's incredible. I also, one other thing is I do life insurance, which most families don't have, which is extremely important. Why they don't have it, I don't know. It's very simple, it's very cost effective. And you gotta understand, your income is part of that. It's what we call income protection, really. It's not about whether or not you die, it's just more of making sure your family is not gonna be financially devastated if you were to suddenly pass away.
Not even if, it's going to happen to each and every one of us. So we kind of blindly go through life thinking, well, nothing's going to happen to any of us, but we know that it does. And so we need to prepare, because no one wants to leave their spouse and their children in a place where they can't properly mourn when that occurs. And we have seen that all too many times when, now I encourage, a very inexpensive.
So what I do is term life insurance. That is the most inexpensive, the most cost-effective way to protect your family. You can get a lot of coverage for a very low amount, and you would spread it out over a certain amount of terms. And then in the meantime, what we would do is something to make sure that you're growing your investments. So when your investments hit a certain period of amount, so for an example, if you had a $250,000 life insurance policy, but we help grow your investments to $250,000, now you really don't need life insurance anymore,
because
now you're self-insured.
Exactly, and that's the way. Now, I do have term life insurance. I've had it for a long time. I have a couple of policies. I think that it's a non-negotiable. It's like food, housing, shelter, term life insurance. That over cable, that over, Starbucks, over anything else, you need to get term life insurance. And like Mike was saying, I look at it a little differently. I looked at it like when I get out of debt, that's when I no longer need my term life insurance. So whatever term that is, you get a 20-year term life insurance. It should not even take you that long to get out of debt. Get your money right so that when it expires, you're fine. You're fully covered, and you have a peace of mind, because that underlying stress wears on your health. It wears on your relationships. It makes it more difficult to go to work. It's just Like any way that we can get rid of that stress in our life, that's the ticket.
That's the way to go, yes. Exactly.
Less
stress
is
the best. But what I was going to add is that a lot of times I'll come across families, I go, wow, we don't need that. And I go, why not? I mean, you're spending how much on car insurance? Oh, about $150, $160. Well, why would you spend that much on car insurance but won't spend even a third of that just on life insurance? Look, you can replace a car, can't replace an income. So if you have a spouse, if you're watching this now, right now, and you don't have life insurance, and say your spouse is the breadwinner, hey, you should really strongly consider making sure that the breadwinner at least has some kind of protection for you and your family.
Absolutely. So Mike, we talked earlier about time, money, work. How do we make our own rules? What are some things associated with time, money, and work that can help get us into a position?
That's an interesting question. I remember when we just reviewed it, I was really thinking about that. I guess mostly, and you can interject any time, but for me it's more just having the schedule in place every day. I know exactly what I'm going to do every hour of every day, and I want to make sure every hour of every day is productive, or at least close to being productive, whether it's building my business or making sure you put time, set aside time for your family, things like that. And I think you'll know after a while, after you've done this for a while, when you're scheduling your day the day before and really preparing, it makes life a lot easier. I think it also relieves some of that stress too.
It does.
Because you already know what you're doing the next day. You don't want to wake up every morning and go, what am I going to do today? Mm-hmm. I got to go to my job and that'll take all day, and well, what am I gonna do after that? And things like that.
True. When
Anything
you do schedule,
you
when
add?
You do schedule your day, I am busier now than I've ever been. I work seven days a week, and I actually have more quality time with my family than I have ever had. And I'm telling you, I used to go home from work early and work as few hours as possible, and I did not have the quality time that I do right now. And it really comes from life in general is so much better. And once you get debt free, once you get your life insurance, once you get your trust in place, and we can talk about that at another time, but there's certain steps, and it may seem a little out of reach, but it's literally baby steps to getting you there. And once you do, that's it.
There
life gets so much better.
It definitely makes life a lot better.
But definitely you need to be working. Part of that, making your own rules, is you need to work. You need to put in the time. You need to get a second job if that's what you need to do to get out of debt, to do it in a timely manner. No one wants to do this over a huge amount of time. You really need to set it up and light a fire on it and get it done. Or else you're going to be overwhelmed. You're going to get bored with it. And then you're gonna revert back to old habits.
Right. Definitely want to commit to it. I'm gonna use that word again, commit. If you don't commit to it, it's not gonna happen.
So is the advice that people are getting about money, personal finances, and retirement incorrect?
In certain cases, yes. I think that old school thought process still is out there where my grandma and grandpa told me to save my money and put it in a bank. But what they don't understand is that the banks are charging less than 1% of interest. And then what the banks do with your money is they're investing it in the global market, making 12, 13, 15% off of your money. And then when the time comes where you take your money years down the road, they give you your small portion, then they keep the rest.
I thought I heard yesterday that it takes almost 900 years to double your money if you just have it in a bank.
At
that low
less
interest
1%,
percent.
Yeah. even if you look at the Rule 72, even if you were to find a 3% rate of return on your money, it'll still take 24 years for that money to double. So let's take an example, $10,000, just for an example here today. It'll take 24 years for that money to double. And how do I know that? Because I took the number 72 and I divided it by 3, and that equals 24 years. Now, if you can find 6% and you divide that by 72, now it only takes 12 years to double your money. But the reason why we talk about global investing is because those are averaging around 12%, 10 to 12, give or take. But if we go by 12%, now your money's doubling every 6 years. And these are the things the bank doesn't want you to know about. They just want you to be fearful that, oh, you got to put your money in the bank because it's safe. Well, that's what they're saying. It's safely losing money is what it's doing.
Now, how many people out there actually even take the time to take a look at their 401k investments and look at the breakdown of what they have it invested in and seeing the overall rate of return for the lifetime of the mutual funds?
Right.
Probably not very many. And once you start looking at that, your eyes are really going to be opened.
Yes, and that's one of the big things I've done over the last so many years is I've helped a lot of people. I don't tell them what to invest in when it comes to their 401k. I bring an educational approach. I want them to see how these work. What is a mutual fund? What does this or that mean? And that's what I show them. I show them, like Michelle just said, the breakdown of the mutual fund and how long and, you know, what's it been averaging and things like that. Because there's so much information and most people would look at it and not understand it. So I like to educate people on how to invest properly in their 401k. And again, not just show them what to invest in, but why. Why are we investing in this?
Mm-hmm. Where is money on your hierarchy of importance?
It's near the top, but only because of not to be greedy or anything. It's more of just money gives you options. When you have money, you have options to do things that you want to do, whether it's take a vacation or spend more time with the kids, things like that. That's really the whole purpose of money. That's how I look at it, at least. Mm-hmm. Is that how you look at
it?
As a tool. It's not, it's, again, having extra money is what it gives you and your family, that extra time or vacations.
The freedom, the power of choice, the mm-hmm. power of time, the power of everything in your life.
Yes.
That's just the way society set up this, you know, right now, and we're playing the game.
That's right. And then if you notice, a lot of times they try to, what's the word I'm looking for? They try to propaganda having so much money and how it's a bad thing or something. Mm-hmm. It's definitely not a bad thing. Those who are wealthy or rich, we shouldn't always look at them in a negative way. They all worked hard just to reach those goals, just like we did, most of them at least. So I don't think we should be looking at them in a bad way.
Absolutely not.
They just have better options. They have more options.
Actually, we should be looking at it quite the opposite. You should not be, look at your friends around you. Where are they at mm-hmm. financially? Are those the people that you want to be like? I have read so many books. I have had money coaches. I have had whatever I want to do better at, I get a coach in. Mm-hmm. I've had, yes, like I said, when I wanted to get debt free, I got a money coach. Mm-hmm. When I wanted to learn about health, I got a health coach. Yep. And no matter what I want to learn about, I will invest my money. And that's how you use it as a tool to get you where you want. Absolutely. You cannot put a price on making your, improving your life and the life of your family and your legacy. And I think that's what a lot of it is about, is legacy.
Yes. And one last note, look at some of the wealthy people go, oh, they're so wealthy and they got all this money. Hey, look, most of them wrote a book to teach you on how to make more money. Mm-hmm. So it's not like they're just taking their money and running and saying the heck with everyone else. They all have, you can go into any bookstore and see tons of books from millionaires and billionaires who said, here's how I did it. You can do it too if you want, if you have that commitment.
Absolutely. So what are you playing for? What's your why?
My family.
Your family.
Easily. That's mm-hmm. that's an easy answer. Not only just to do well and build a business and things like that, but you all know, most of you should know at least, that your kids are watching, your spouse is watching, and it's not just about me. It's about all of us, all, you know, them, and being that role model for my two sons, they can look at dad and say, yeah, dad did it. You all can do it, but you got to commit to wanting to do it. Mm-hmm. But keep in mind, those children are watching you. So don't forget that.
By the way, Michael and I are going to do a private stream for anyone who gets a hold of him or who buys 10 or more books of the book that I wrote, Rethinking Life, the guidebook for recreating your life and winning the game. So either way, you get a hold of Michael, or if you buy 10 books or more, and you know, that's not for me. Like I was telling Mike, this is information that needs to get out there. The cost of the book, you know, you can give it to the people and bring everybody up in your circle. Anyone could use this. It's the person that's starting out. You know, I wrote the book for my children so that they don't have to go through the struggles that their dad and I had to go through, and so that they can bypass that and live a much more happy, enjoyable, fulfilled, purposeful life at a younger age than what we were able to do.
Right.
And so you can email Michael. What's your email, Mike?
It's cowboysfan3143@gmail.com.
Or you can find Rethinking Life, the guidebook for recreating your life and winning the game, on Amazon.com. Michelle Laura Romero. So, debt. Would you borrow money?
From who?
Well, that's a good question. I am asking the questions.
I come across so many families that tell me right on the first meeting, oh, I just have so much debt, Mike. I can never get out of this, never get out of this. And I look over their debt and I document it, and I come back and go, here's your plan. You could be debt-free in 3 or 4 years. And the shock in their eyes of, oh my gosh, really? Yes, because what I just did for them is I put a plan together for them. I showed them step by step how to eliminate debt. That's what I believe is one of the major issues in America today, is that not only are we racking up a lot of debt, but no one is showing families how to get out of debt. It's just more of how to get more into debt. And it's a simple plan that you just, a formula, a plan, however you want to call it, what we call it debt stacking, but it's simply a plan on how to get out of debt, knock out one debt, take that extra money, put it towards the next one, and then the next one, and the next one, and you can be debt-free pretty fast if you at least commit, again, I use that word again, commit, commit to that plan, commit to that philosophy that you can do it. If you put your mind to it and you put your heart to it, and it can happen.
College, student loans. What do you think?
Another major issue in America. I think you and I, we had talked about college, how I'm not a big fan of college if it's going to cost six figures or more. Now, I understand certain people need to go to college. Doctors, you want to be a lawyer, engineer, things like that. But I'm a big fan of training and technical type schools where it won't cost as much to learn a trade if it's something you want to do or you're passionate about. College debt now is already in the trillions, and it's crazy. It's mind-boggling too to see kids in their 20s already in debt, six figures.
Mm-hmm.
That's not a good way to start your career and your life. So I think it's a happy medium type of deal. Only, you know, and here let me just say this: a lot of problems that I'm coming across is people are going to college, and then they get their degree and they go, I don't want to do that.
Because in your 20s, you probably don't know what you want to do anyway.
Right.
But when my older children were growing up, I automatically thought all through their elementary years, they're going to go to college. They're going to go to college. And I really steered them toward college until they were in high school and junior high. And I saw the mess that was happening.
Right.
And after that, I thought, no way. And I completely stopped steering them that way and encouraged them to get jobs, to learn skills, to follow their passions. And if they did want to go to college, what they were going to do was go to community college. Mm-hmm. They were going to get jobs. They were going to pay. And then if they passed their classes, I would be more than happy to pay them back.
Right.
If they didn't, then they were going to be stuck with the bill. But one of them tried that for a little bit, and it's just not his thing. That's totally fine with me. I'm actually happy with that. So he's working, he's saving money, and I would much rather see him buy a piece of property that he could even rent out and have income from that. Now that would make me very happy. That's a much better way to get wealthy than to go into debt, because Mike and I both know you don't have to go to college to make money. We know hundreds and hundreds of people, if not more, that make plenty of income without going to college. So save your money. If you're going to go work, pay cash, fill out scholarships, do what you have to do, but do not go under the student loans.
Agreed.
Did you go to college? Did we talk
about
this?
I did a 2-year community college. I got a certificate in computer repair at that time. So it wasn't really expensive. I did have a few little scholarships. So, yeah, I didn't go into debt or anything from going to college.
Good.
So, yeah, that's definitely, like Michelle said, if it's going to put you in a lot of debt, it's really probably not worth it. Unless you're really passionate about being the next doctor or the next nurse or the next engineer or lawyer. Mm-hmm. Something really up there where you have to do a lot of years of education.
And then the same thing goes about working your way through it. I mean, there's nothing saying you have to do it in a certain period of time. I think it's much better to leave school debt-free.
Yes, absolutely.
So tell us a story about how you changed your life and found your purpose. How did you know that you wanted to get into the financial sector?
I did have some influence in the field. I had a friend who was in the field, and it was one of those thinking that, you might do well at this. You should at least take a look at it. And of course, I was open by that time because of what I'd said earlier about looking for some purpose in my life. And once I sat down with this person and we went over everything, it all made sense to me that, this could be something. This could be what I've been looking for. But still, you don't know when you first start out. We all know that. But as I got into it and started learning some more, I started really seeing the big impact that not only that I'm learning, but how I can share this with others, because that's the main thing, is sharing information with others that they probably don't know too much about. So that's I was on my way after that, because once I sat down with a few families and they saw the impact, it started making sense to me that, this is the direction I want to go. I want to keep going out there and helping more and more families, because the middle class is being ignored.
It truly is. What's the biggest mistake that you ever made, money-wise?
I did a consolidation loan. And this was years ago. This is probably about 15 years ago. I did a consolidation loan. And what I didn't know at that time was there would have been a penalty for paying it off early. Yeah. And here we were, a year or two later, we were knocking it out a lot quicker, to the point where we got it down to zero. And then we got a penalty because we paid it off early. Hmm. So... keep an eye on that bottom line.
Yeah, read the fine print.
That little fine print. So that I learned from that, that's not going to happen again.
No, you're not going to be in that position again.
Never.
Why did you come here today?
Because I believe in what you're doing.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
The great thing is, what I want you both to understand who's watching this, we're on the same page. Mm-hmm. We've been talking for... how many years now about this, between the what she knows and understands and what I know and what I understand, and we're just a great match on a combination of, you know, Michelle's teaching you how to rethink your life and how to focus on your future, and me, I'm more on the side of, part of that is the financial side of focusing on rethinking your life financially. And so together we know we bring a lot of great information that we can share with everybody to get yourself on track.
And we've been there, and we've made the mistakes, and we've overcome the mistakes, and it's okay, because no matter how far down you are, you can get out.
Yes, as long as you
self-discipline.
If you're disciplined and you want to do it, you can do it.
What would you do differently if you were me? I'm asking for advice.
Ooh, wow. Well, we've talked in the past about, I know you're a little more focused on real estate investing. I am not, because of what I know, I'm less real estate investing. Not to say that's a bad thing. If you have the money, go invest in real estate if you wish. I'm more of the investing in like mutual funds and things like that, because I believe they bring greater returns. So that's the only difference. You and I always will always have that.
Agree to disagree.
Yeah. So there, that answers your question.
And that's okay, because there's more than one way to freedom.
Yes.
That's for sure. I mean, that's never going to change.
That's never going to change.
So I want to do a reminder here that Michael and I are going to do a collaboration, a stream for anyone who buys 10 or more books or who contacts Michael. And can you give him the email again?
Sure. Cowboys, that's plural, fan, F-A-N, 3143 at gmail.com.
Gmail. Ask Mike and Michelle, and we'll give you a shout out and a private stream before the end of May. Let's do that, okay?
Sounds great.
Who's the real Michael DeLeon?
The real Michael DeLeon is a devout Christian and a devout family man. And again, who 10 years ago found purpose in his life. One of the other things, when I'm not helping families get on the right track, I do like to play golf from time to time. And I am a big baseball fan. How's that?
I like it. Give me a one word, your first thought. I'll give you a word and you give me your thought, okay? Job. First thought.
Oh my gosh. That first thought? Enjoy what you do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Work.
If work? Just one word, huh?
Just one word, or your first thought on work.
Work hard.
That's it. Money.
That's it. Save.
Success.
Achievable.
Failure.
Part of growing. I'm sorry, I said more than one word there.
That's okay, you can say that.
Okay.
Vacation. We might disagree on this.
As long as it doesn't put you in debt.
There you go. I was gonna say vacation, no. Work. Go back to work.
First.
Okay, hustle.
It's part of the game.
It's part of the game. It's necessary.
Yes.
Competition.
Keeps the fire burning.
It does. What's your mission? Sorry, what's your mission?
To achieve financial independence.
All right, back to the one words. Interviews. What do you think of this?
If it helps one person, it's worth it.
I love that. Now, do you do speaking?
Sometimes within my team, of course.
Okay.
Within our...
What do you think of that?
As far as what, speaking?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I love when I get a chance to speak.
Get you all pumped up,
I'm sure. Gets me all pumped up. It gets my thoughts revved up on what I want to say and what I want to everyone to hear.
All right. We got a strategic player right here, Michael DeLeon. I want you to be in this chair one day right here on Rethinking Life. We bring you someone generous enough like Michael and somebody that's actually doing it, living their purpose and providing value. Michael, thank you for being here.
Oh, this is great. Thank you so much, Michelle.